Goiters, rickets, scurvy. These diseases may seem like ancient history, but did you know that these diseases are still present today? Even though science has come so far with understanding nutrition, patterns within the United States and England are showing signs of certain nutrition-related diseases re-emerging. Before we dive into each condition, let's first discuss what we mean by the term re-emerging. Re-emerging means that a condition was once a problem, was then solved through food or supplementation, but is now being seen again in developed countries. These diseases are often called Victorian or English diseases, as many of them were seen and researched within the English population or present during Queen Victoria's reign. These diseases are still rare, but they have increased, and current dietary trends may lead to more cases in the near future. The first re-emerging nutritional disease we will discuss are goiters. Goiters are caused by an iodine deficiency and result in the swelling of the thyroid gland that can be seen in the photo on the left. Iodine deficiency can also result in hypothyroidism, altered metabolism, and poor fetal brain development. Goiters used to be prevalent in the 1800s and the early 1900s, until table salt was iodized in the 1920s. This resulted in goiters becoming virtually non-existent in developed countries that could manufacture salt in this way. By the 1940s, the problem of goiters was considered solved. The main sources of dietary iodine include iodized salt, which is most table salts, dairy products, seafood, and grains. Iodine deficiency and the presence of goiters are still rare, but there has been a significant increase in moderate and severe cases. This is due to several factors. First, not all salts sold are iodized, including sea salt, kosher salt, and Himalayan salt, which have all risen in popularity. Additionally, most processed foods that are high in sodium don't use iodized salt. Some people restrict added salt while following a heart-healthy diet. There is also an increased avoidance to dairy and seafood due to allergies, intolerances, and general preferences. Rickets has often been called the disease of English children, as many English children suffered from this during the Victorian era. Rickets occurs due to poor bone mineralization from a lack of vitamin D or calcium. This results in leg deformities, typically seen as bowed legs, bone pain, hypocalcemia, and delayed motor development in children. Research on how to cure rickets began in the mid-1600s. This led to the understanding that cod liver oil and sunlight seemed to cure rickets, but there was no understanding on why and that it could be prevented. After the First World War, the Sunshine Movement began, which emphasized the use of ultraviolet lamps to cure rickets in children. In 1922, researchers published a paper stating that a vitamin was responsible for helping to deposit calcium into the bones. Why are rickets returning? The first theory is that breast milk is a poor source of vitamin D unless the mother is taking a supplement. Additionally, populations in developed countries today are not exposed to sunlight as much and use much more sunscreen. As mentioned with iodine, dairy consumption has decreased, contributing to rickets. Some English scientists even believe the increased prevalence of rickets is due to increased cloud coverage. Scurvy is caused by a vitamin C deficiency. Early symptoms include fatigue and irritability, which make it often go undiagnosed. Later symptoms include bleeding or swollen gums, slow wound healing, and pin-sized bleeding underneath the skin. Historically, scurvy was seen in 18th century sailors who went for long voyages without access to citrus fruits. Many even lost their lives. It was later discovered that scurvy could be prevented by sending barrels of lime or lemon juice along with the sailors. Scurvy re-emergence is more rare than rickets or goiters, but it has been seen more often within a few high-risk populations. These include those that follow very restrictive diets that often exclude fruits due to their sugar content. Additionally, low income can result in poor diet. People that excessively smoke, drink, or do drugs are also at risk, while certain medications can affect vitamin C status. As of 2012, 7.1% of the U.S. adult population was found to be vitamin C deficient. Gout occurs during a state of hyperuricemia, which means there is too much uric acid within the blood. This high level results in very painful inflammation anywhere in the body. Gout can be caused by diet, obesity status, a family history of the disease, and even other conditions, such as hypertension. While gout was not very prevalent historically, it was always viewed as the disease of the wealthy and influential during the Victorian era. Gout is considered to be re-emerging because researchers and healthcare providers have once again focused their attention on the disease, as over 8 million Americans are now suffering from it. In summary, goiters, rickets, and scurvy, while still rare, have increased in prevalence over the past few decades. Gout has re-entered the developed world from being a disease only for the wealthy to one that is experienced by millions. Preventions of these diseases are simple. Eat a balanced diet with a wide variety of fruits and vegetables. While consuming added salt, use iodized salt. And remember to get plenty of vitamin D through sunlight or supplementation.